researchers at Cornell decided to figure out some practical uses for an extra robotic arm. They discovered it's more useful for professional and work settings, where it's helpful to hold multiple things at once, rather than recreational uses like an extra arm for rock climbing.
Although that would be cool.
And also at Guy Hoffman's lab, Blossom is a social home robot made out of soft, handcrafted materials like yarn and wood instead of the usual plastic, glass, and metal. Honestly, I just wanted to show you this because it's the first companion robot I've wanted to hug. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. Ohio State researchers have a one-touch organ healing device. The tissue nanotransfection technology allows doctors to generate any cell type within a patient's body to repair injured tissue or restore organs, blood vessels, and nerve cells. By placing the chip on the body and applying electrical current, the non-invasive reprogramming turns skin cells into whatever cells doctors need. It injects DNA into the skin cells, and it worked on a mouse to restore blood flow to a damaged leg in just 3 weeks. And they're beginning human clinical trials for this in 2018. We may have discovered the building blocks for quantum internet. Researchers at the Australian National University used an ion called erbium in a crystal to store quantum information for over a second, 10,000 times longer than previous experiments. It also works with existing fiber optic networks and can connect to different quantum computers. And one great advantage of developing the quantum internet is security. It would allow for information to be destroyed if intercepted. There is a pen that can detect cancer in real time. The mass spec pen developed at the University of Texas at Austin works by delivering a water droplet to a tissue surface, which extracts biomolecules, which are then delivered to a mass spectrometer for molecular analysis. The system then tells surgeons whether the tissue is cancerous or not in seconds, allowing for safer and more effective cancer removal surgery. The first winged mammals evolved 100 million years earlier than the first modern mammal flyers. Two 160 million year old Jurassic period fossils were uncovered in China, and a collaboration between the University of Chicago and Beijing Museum of Natural History resulted in these awesome reconstructions. And this discovery shows the ecological diversity of early mammals, suggesting dinosaurs were not quite as dominant as previously thought. Neurable created the first brain-controlled virtual reality game. The Brain Computer Interface Company interprets brain activity using an EEG to measure electric activity and software to translate it into action. Their device uses 7 electrodes that measure signals responding to stimuli, so you can play their game Awakenings without controllers. You literally just use your brain. The plan is to make this available in VR arcades next year. Meanwhile, in Japan, rural elderly folks are getting around in autonomous robot buses. They've begun experimenting with driverless buses to shuttle the elderly to medical and shopping services in rural areas without enough workers to drive taxis or buses. Right now, the robot shuttle tops out at 6 miles per hour, so hopefully as they develop the technology, they can improve the travel time before their projected launch in 2020. Nanobiotics are a new class of antibiotics. Engineers from Michigan University can create nanoparticles 1/100th the size of a germ of different shapes to control what they do. So by using these to coat medical devices, they bind to the proteins to prevent molecules from changing, thereby creating bacteria resistance, which could be a huge advance in the fight against antibiotic resistance. Scientists at the University of Texas at Dallas have developed electricity-generating yarn. The carbon nanotube Twistron yarn generates electricity when stretched, and one of the future uses of this technology could be harvesting energy from ocean waves. Finally, smart self-driving wheelchairs are continuing their development with hospital trials in Singapore.
The technology will give people much more flexibility and much richer personal mobility, and at the same time, it will make it better for the doctors and the nurses who will focus on patient care and will be less worried about whether they have the right objects or the right people in the right place.
Over the years, MindBlow has focused on breakthrough ideas, discoveries, and science to push us all forward. The world has been on an incredible path of progress. In our lifetimes, we've witnessed the biggest decrease in poverty, disease, and child deaths. But progress is not inevitable. So the Gates Foundation is creating the Goalkeepers Report, which they hope will inspire a new generation of leaders. Goalkeepers who raise awareness of progress, hold their leaders accountable, and drive action to accelerate progress. Education is an area where the world doesn't have enough data to understand progress. It's relatively easy to count the number of children in school, but that doesn't tell us how much those children are actually learning. Many countries don't generate any useful learning data at all, let alone in a comparable way. We need to know early whether children are able to read, a prerequisite to all learning. So, for more information on ways to get involved in ensuring quality education to transform our world, click the link to read the report. Now I'm going to leave you with two walking robots taking a stroll through the Agility Robotics office, and as always, thanks for watching.
Bookmaking is older than printing by many centuries. Yet today's members of the Brotherhood of Bookbinders, artists of the AFL-CIO, are able to supply the demand for the most important ingredient of the modern world, literacy. Following a craft as ancient as cave drawings, these union workers of the book industry are second to none in keeping pace with progress. The ingenuity which has been passed on to the folders, gatherers, sewers, trimmers, liners, and casemakers in a proud profession is constantly at work for you to produce our greatest treasure, knowledge.